now that we're getting the hang of unguided bombing, we're going to move on to using unguided rockets. We have many rocket types loaded for this lesson, but they're all delivering the same energy. Basically, point and shoot when within range. We'll keep this lesson in active pause mode as we discuss unguided rockets. Press the space bar to continue. Take a look at the weapon status panel in the bottom center of the front page. See that except for the most outer and inner stations, all stations are loaded with rockets, indicated by the red lights. In the top right corner of the panel is a dashed field that indicates the selected weapon type. Currently, no weapon type is selected. Let's select rockets now by entering area ground mode. Press 7. Great. Now we're in area ground mode, and you can see HPC, which indicates rockets, showing the current weapon field. You can also see green lights on the active weapon station page. In this case, the second most outdoor station on the right wing. In the lower right portion, we're provided the name of the selected rocket type. You can see S5, which indicates the S5 rocket, which is housed in the UB-32A rocket pod. This is a rather small rocket with a high explosive range. Press D to select the next rocket type. The next rocket type is the SA-KOA. This rocket uses the B-8M1 rocket pod with 20 rockets per pod. The rocket is 82 millimeters in diameter, has a range of about 2 kilometers, and has a shaped charge warhead, which is good against armor. Press D to select the next rocket type. This is the S-13OF, which is held forward to a B-13L rocket. The rocket is larger than the S-5 and S-8, having a diameter of 122 millimeters. It has a blast fragmentation warhead and has a range of about 2 kilometers. High explosive and blast fragmentation warheads are best used against unarmored and lightly armored targets. However, a direct hit on an armored vehicle may destroy it, depending on the size of the warhead. Press D to select the next rocket type. This 24B is your largest rocket, with a diameter of 600 millimeters and a mass of 235 kilogram blast fragmentation warhead. Given its size, the S-24B is not housed in a pod, but rather directly attached to the weapon station. Press D to select the next rocket type. The other large rocket at your disposal is the S-25OFM, with a diameter of 340 millimeters and 190 kilogram warhead. This rocket has the longest range and can reach out to 3 kilometers. Each rocket is housed in a single launch tube. Press D to select the next rocket type. The final rocket is the S-8OFP-2. Like the KOM version, it's an 82mm rocket with 20 rockets per pod. However, this one has a blast fragmentation warhead. Press D to return to the S-5 rocket. Press the spacebar to unpause the lesson and fly through all the gates ahead. As we're en route to the target, we can practice your low-level ingress skills. Nearing the target, we'll initiate a pop-up attack. In the middle portion of your HUD is your rocket aiming reticle. Much like the bombing reticle, this indicates where the rockets will land if you launch them at that instant. However, the range must be within minimum and maximum range value of the selected rocket type. Left side of the HUD is the rocket launch zone indication. The top bar indicates the maximum range of the rocket, and the bottom bar indicates the minimum safe range. The carrot moves vertically along the left side of the HUD to indicate your current range based on where the rocket aiming reticle is placed. When the carrot is between the maximum and minimum range bars, the range is valid. When your selected rocket type is within range, a launch authorization cue will appear on the HUD. next gate, we'll start our climb. Make sure your speed is above 700 kilometers per hour. As you pass through the top gate, roll the aircraft inverted and pull the nose down to the target. The target is marked with red smoke. When aligned with the target, roll the wings level while keeping the aiming reticle over the target. Press the spacebar to fire the rockets when you see the LA crew in the HUD.
Begin the Peter Pascal.